Hello everyone, welcome to LRDA Prep. My name is Sameer Sardana and in this video I'm going to discuss a very important concept, that's ranking concept for you. So you can learn the complete concept of ranking by watching this video, and there are also more such videos on ranking that I have already uploaded on the channel of LRDA Prep. If you like the video, please rate the video and share it. Guys, my name is Sameer Sardana. I have done my MBA from University Business School, Punjab University, and I'm teaching on Unacademy Plus for CAT. For Quant and DALR section, I have an experience of 10 years teaching for CAT exam. You can attend my live classes on Unacademy Plus using my referral code LRDASMEERLIVE. This will give you a 10% off on Plus subscription. Now let's have a look at the set that we are supposed to discuss in this video. Direction says, read the information given below and answer the questions that follows. Each of six runners, A, B, C, D, E, F, participated in a race which had two events, R1 and R2. At the end of the event, each runner was given a position in each of the two events from 1 to 6. The runner who was the winner got first position, and the runner who finished at the end got the sixth position. So guys, we have two races, right? Two races are given to us, race 1 and race 2. And the number of participants are A, B, C, D, E, and F. And using these hints, we are supposed to determine the ranks of each of these six persons in race 1 and race 2. All right. So basically, we are supposed to find out the ranking here. It is also known that for any runner, the sum of the position of that runner in the two event is not an even number. Now that's a very important information that you need to interpret it. You just don't read it and move forward. No, you need to understand how does it make sense, how this information is related to the table that we are trying to fill. What information that you can infer from this statement that the summation of both of these two rank has to be should not be an even number. Now, how do you find the summation of two values as an even number? Either both of the numbers should be odd, then I'll get the summation as even, or even plus even will also be equal to even. Now, the summation of both of the ranks should not be even. That means one of the rank has to be odd, the other rank has to be even. If one of the rank has to be odd, the other has to be even. That means both of these two rank for a particular person should be different. That means if I am giving a rank 2 to B in R1, I cannot give 2 to B in R2, because in that case, both of these two values will become 4. So both of the ranks are different. That's the point that you need to infer from the first statement, which is a very important one. Now, second statement says, B finished later than C in race 1. Now, in race 1, okay, race 1, race 2, A, B, C, D, E, F. B finished later than C in race 1. So, just use this information, B. Okay. So, if B is finishing later than C, that means rank of B will be lower than C, right? When I say the lower, in terms of magnitude, the rank of B would be higher than C, right? Right, more is the magnitude value of the rank. That means you are finishing the race later. The person who will be finishing the race who will be winning the race will be ranked as 1 as per the statement here. So B is finishing later than C. That means C's rank must be, in terms of magnitude, must be lower than the rank of B, right? The difference in the position of A in R1 and the position of D in the race R2 is 2. The difference in the position of A in R1. So if I say the position of A in R1 is X and the position of D in race R2 is, let's say, Y, then the difference of these two values, that means X and Y, has to be 2. Which value will be more in terms of magnitude? That's not given. Simply, it says the difference has to be equal to 2. X can be more than Y, so that you can say the magnitude of X and Y would be equal to 2. X can be more than Y, or X can also be less than Y. C, who was third in race 2. Now, it's given that C was third in race 2, got better position than at least 3 runners in race 1. Now, C's rank is better than at least 3 positions. So, that means there are at least 3 person who will be finishing the race after C. At least 3. There can be more than 3. That means there will be at least 3. Now, when I say that the C rank is at least the 3 person, which are the minimum number of people who are finishing the race after C, can I say the rank of C cannot be 4? Because if I give rank 4 to C, that means 2 people will be finishing after C. But because it says 3 people are there, at least 3 people are there who are finishing the race after C, the possible option for the rank of C will either be 1 or it would be 2 or it would be 3. Right? Either it would be 1 or 2 or 3. It cannot be 4. Now observe it. Can I put 1 here? If I put 1 here, 3 plus 1 will be 4. So 1 is not possible for C, right? Can I put 3 here? If I put 3 here, 3 plus 3 will become 6, which is an even number. So 3 is also eliminated. Can I say there is only one possible option for C, and that is 2, right? So the rank of C in race 1 will be 2, right? So we get this information, right? All right, let's move forward now. What else the question says? C, who was 13? Okay, we have used this information, statement number 4. Let's read the next statement. D, who was at a worse position than at least 3 runner in race 1 race, in the R1 race, was at a worse position than E in R2 race. Now, this is an information that says D, who was at a worse position than at least 3 runner. D, who was at worse position at least 3 runner, that means the number of people in race 1 who are finishing the race before D are at least 3. The minimum value is at least 3. That means there are minimum 3 number of people who are finishing the race before D. So the rank of D, the possible option for rank of D, because there are 6 people who are participating, at least 3 people are finishing the race before D. So rank of D can be either 4 or 5 or 6. It cannot be 3, because in case you give rank 3 to D, then 2 people will be finishing ahead of D. We need at least 3. So the possible option for the rank of D would be 4, 5 or 6. Right? So the value over here for D can either be 4 or it can be 5 or it can be 6. Was at a worse position, or the same line is talking about D again, was at a worse position than E in the R2 race. Was at a worse position than E in R2 race. In the race 2, the rank D is finishing after E, because the rank of D is worse than E. That means D is finishing after E. Right? All right, let's move forward. F was 4th in race 1. F was 4th in race 1. This number is 4. And was at a worse position than D in race 2. F is finishing after D in race 2, right? So because F rank is given over here as 4, can I eliminate the option of D having the rank of 4, right? So we will be left with these two cases. D rank will be either 5 or it will be 6. Now, one information that we are yet to use is this one. And you can also see that if B is finishing after C, the possible option for the B rank would be either 3, or it can, 4 is already there, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the possible option for B, because B is finishing the race after C, right? Let's see now. Now let's use this information, the difference in the magnitude of the rank of A in R1 and the position of D in R2 is 2. X minus Y has to be 2. Now, if I write down the 6 numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and if I'm supposed to find out the pairs in such a way that difference has to be 2, the possible option is 1 and 3 is a possible option, 2 and 4 is a possible option, and 3 and 5 is possible, or 4 and 6 is possible, right? 1, 3, 2, 4, 3, 5, and 4, 6. All of these pairs have a difference of 2. Now, If I am putting one here, then to make a difference of two, I need to put three here. But three is already used, so this is eliminated, right? So can I say one cannot come over here, okay? What if I take a value of 3 and 1? So can I take 3 and 1? If I put 3 here, to make a difference of 2, I need to put 1 here. This is again eliminated. Why? Because D is finishing the race after E in R2. So can I give 1 to D? No. 1 rank to D is not possible, right? So you need to eliminate this case, right? So this case will be eliminated. That means 1, 3 as a combination which have a difference of 2 is eliminated. Now let's pick the next case, 2 and 4. If 2 is not possible here, if I give 2 here, then 2 is already used by C. So 2 is not possible. What if I give 4 here? If I give 4th rank over here, then I need to give 2 rank over here, right? 4 and 2, that's a possible option, right? 4 and 2 will give you a difference of 2. Okay, let's keep this, right? We'll decide later whether this will be eliminated or not. Okay, what if I have to take a 3 and 5? If I give 3 to X here, then I need to give 5 to Y here. Now, D is getting a rank of 5. Okay, that's a possible option. Okay, but if I give 5 here, then I need to give 3 here. 5 and 3 will not be possible because 3 has already been used. What about 4 and 6? 4 and 6 are also at a difference of 2. 4 cannot be used here. 4 has already been used. Now, this case is also eliminated. If I'm giving it 4, I need to take 2 here. 4 has already been used by F. So, can I eliminate this particular case? Right? So, 4 is not a possible option here. So, you need to eliminate here, right? 4 is not possible, right? Then you have only this option, 6 and 4. If I go this as a 6, then I need to give 4 here. Will it work? This is a possible option. This can work, right? 6 and 4 have a difference of 2. 3 or 5 have a difference of 2. So we finally come down to two possible cases. If I want to maintain a difference of 2 between A's rank in race 1 and D's rank in race 2, the possible option are 6, 4 and 3, 5. All right. Then do we have any other information about A? We don't have any other information. Okay. B finished later than C in race 1. Okay. And the difference in, we are using this, C who was third in race 2 got better position than at least 3 runner in race 1. We have sorted out this issue. D who was at a worse position than at least 3 runner in race 1. Okay. Was at a worse position than E in the race 2. Okay. F was at a fourth position in R1 and was at a worse position than D. F was at a worse position than D in R2 race. F was at a worse position than D in R2 race. Now, see that. If I give a rank 5 to D, let's say, these are the two cases I have. If I am taking 6 here, 4 here, then if I am taking 3 here, then I'll be taking 5 here. Now, see that if I am taking 5, if a case of 3 and 5, now, to make F worse than D, I need to give a rank 6 to F. Now, 6 plus 4 will become 10 and the summation will become an even number. So, you need to eliminate this case. That means this cannot work. 6 cannot come here. If 6 cannot come here, that means 5 cannot come here. If 5 cannot come here, that means 3 cannot come here. So, that means 6 and 4 will be the possible case here, right? So, 6 will come here, right? This one. Alright, so 6 will come here, right? 6 will come here and 4 will come here. So we get to know these two ranks will be 6 and 4. Let's fill this information. This is definitely 6 and this is definitely 4. Right. Okay. Now this is 6, this is 4, right? And now I want the summation of both of these two values to be an odd number, not an even. So 6 will be eliminated here. So the only possible option left here would also be 5. 5 will come here, 4 will come here. Now 5 and 6 are already used. So I'll be left with only these two cases, 3 or 4. But 4 is already used. So the only option for B rank would be 3 here. So the B rank in race 1 would be 3 here, right? So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the only rank that is left is 1, so 1 will come over here. Now, D, F rank is worse than D. F rank is worse than D. So if D rank is 4, F rank will be the 5 or 6. If I put 6 here, 6 plus 4 will become 10. So F only option left is 5. F would be given a rank 5 here, right? And okay, let's talk about E. Now, the rank of E is better than D. So D is 4, so the only option left here is 1, 2 and 3. 1 is already here, so 1 cannot come here. 1 plus 1 will be an even number. 1 is here, 3 cannot come here. 1 plus 3 will also be an even number. So the only option for E is to put 2 here. So the only option for E is to have a rank 2 in R2. So this number will be R2. Now I need to put 1 here also. Right, 2, 3, 4, 5 rank has already been decided in R2. I need to put in both of these two options 1 also. 3 plus 1 will be 4. Summation cannot be an even number. So I need to put 1 here. And the only rank left is now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 will come here. That's it. The grid is completed and now you can answer all the questions. This is how you're supposed to solve a ranking based question in races. That is the concept. You just need to interpret the statement. Use some of your number skill. You need to be comfortable with the numbers. Your quantitative reasoning skills will be really, really helpful in the ranking set. And CAT is keen on these type of set where they might ask you set on ranking, because in the previous year papers, right, you will find a number of sets which are completely based on the ranking concept. So I hope this helped. I'll be giving you the links of the other sessions which are based on ranking in the description part of the video. If you need to practice more set on ranking, please check on the description part of the video. And also, I'll be giving you the link of my profile of Unacademy in the description part of the video, where you can check 500 plus special classes which are completely free that can help you in covering your whole syllabus of CAT exam. Please check on this video if you're preparing for CAT and other MBA entrance exams. There are a number of special classes that I have already taken in the last 3 years on Unacademy. Special classes, these are completely free special classes. Check on the description part. This is my Telegram group for updates on my classes and videos. This is a referral code for the Plus subscription. And there's a practice drill 1.0 for CAT 2021 getting started on Unacademy on 26th of June. And I'm going to do arithmetic and algebra. Arithmetic revision, or you can say the practice, is a 500 must-do questions. And also, this will be on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. And also, algebra 100 questions course. Algebra 100 questions on Saturday and Sunday. This will be also covered under this practice drill. So arithmetic and algebra, both topics can be covered if you join this on Unacademy Plus. Use my referral code LRDSMILIVE to get 10% off on Plus subscription. And if you use this code to come to the platform, I'll be giving you the mentorship for your exam preparation throughout the year. Thanks a lot. See you then in the next part of the video. Thank you.